continue to scale within that solution, or you can plug in outside technologies in there as your needs vary from the standard. So we have actually an example of a virtual system in the HP booth right at the end of this hall. We have our three-part storage array there as well. We have one or two people from our HP networking organization that are available to talk about our networking products as well. We also have a ton of resources out on HP.com to talk about the various virtual system models. Today we have offerings that include VS1, VS2, VS3 for VMware, VS1 and VS2 with Microsoft. We just launched those last week. And we have our Citrix options coming out within the next 6 months. In all cases, we have the reference architectures for all three of those hypervisors also out on HP.com. With that, I reach the end of my slides. Are there any questions about HP Virtual System? Yes?
What challenges are your customers facing in the deployment of a virtual system?
What challenges are customers facing deploying virtual systems?
Yes.
So a lot of the customers I've spoken to are trying to decide how to size the server properly to host virtual machines based on the number of virtual machines they need. Some of them are having to decide which hypervisor they want to work with if they haven't already got a footprint in their environment. The other thing is sizing the storage properly to enable them to not oversubscribe the storage with virtual machines. So they want to make sure they have the proper resources to get the right performance out of the virtual machines. So they don't want to make sacrifices because they're going from a pure physical server environment into virtual. So a lot of it has to do with sizing of the technologies. Also some of the networking, whether they have a flat network or they have multiple levels of their networking, how it all fits together.
What would you say is the average time of deployment for a full system from the hypervisor to the management to the servers, the storage?
So you're asking for average time to deploy? So without the virtual system, I've seen people fumble with it for anywhere from weeks in the design phase to months trying to decide how to get the pieces together. And there's a lot of trial and error where you're putting different pieces of hardware together, determining whether they first will work together or whether they'll achieve proper performance to meet your needs. And sometimes you'll get down a path and decide that it's not going to meet your needs, ultimately you backtrack and have to start putting it back together again from scratch or from an earlier point. So maybe you've standardized on a server, but you need to figure out which options within that server are required. So it can take several months without virtual systems to actually get the virtualization up and running. If you're just starting out into a virtualization type of rollout. With the virtual system, it's a matter of ordering it from HP, and we'll walk you through the steps of sizing it for your environment and choosing the right model. We can very quickly build it in our factory and deploy it very quickly on your floor in a matter of days. So the factory build, I think the longest lead time I've seen that up has been measured in weeks. From the specification on the sales side through the whole purchase process to building it in a factory. And then once it's delivered on site, depending on how much integration help you need, it can be anywhere from a single day to 3 or 4 days.